Hello and welcome to Asybirds, and thanks for stopping by. On today's show, I do a review on this Unimog the RC Elf gifted to me. To keep it straight, I'm not talking about the gift as itself, einem geschenkten Gaul schaut man nicht ins Maul, or a gifted horse you don't look in the mouth. So this review is for the ones out there who are thinking about owning a CR01 car, and for that I think it's okay to say something maybe possibly negative about this car, or do some criticism. For me, this gift as itself is very great for me. I like it. I had a lot of fun by building it, driving it outside. And so I have to thank you, and I say, can't say it often enough. Thank you, RC Elf. This is awesome gift. You made me so happy with this kit. And beside, the greatest gift is that I find so many new channels doing awesome stuff here on YouTube. Very nice guys. And I'm really happy that I found so many of those great people out there. I've a section in my main page of this channel where you find many of these other awesome channels. So please check them out. They are doing great stuff. They are really great guys. And for this, I thank the RC Elf too. You might wonder why there is a big yellow bird behind the car. This is Mo. This Unimog is dedicated to her because she's having already a really bad time. She's losing some feathers and is still on the way to recover from this. You can call it superstition, but maybe it works. Dedicating this car to this little budgie. So now let's start with a review. The first thing I'd like to mention is a manual. It's really good. Tamiya does always very good manuals. You've got the sketches of the parts and screws you need, or the bearings, and an explanation how all fits together. For this manual, you really have to study it. Read it many times and check out where the hints are. So let me give you an example. Yeah. So if you take this step here, this part and this part look almost the same, but this is a middle strength in gold and a hard strength in silver. And right when we get later to the springs, it's just the other way around. Here it said for the front, the hard spring, and for the rear, the medium spring. Marked in yellow, and this is marked in blue. And as I said before, the stabilizer, which are sitting somewhere here, it's just the way around. A hard stabilizer and a medium spring for the front, and medium stabilizer and a hard spring, a medium stabilizer for the front and a hard spring, or two hard springs for the front, and for the rear, the medium springs and the hard stabilizer. And it isn't always set where you are. You have to find it out that this is a rear axle and this is a front axle, but you have here the servo, and in many sketches, the views are taken around, and you have really to read the whole thing. Incomplete, the build is a lot of fun. This car is really for someone who likes to build. There are many screws in. It's a very good technology, and it is not just putting a gearbox and suspension on a chassis frame and then you're fine. It takes a lot of time, takes a lot of attention, but it makes really fun to build this car. The second part of the build is a paint job. It's not really so easy because the body isn't really flat. And especially here in this region, there I had some mistakes, but altogether I'm fine, because I have to say Mo isn't as bright as she is here on this picture. This is a baby photo of her. Now she says a little yellow, green, dirty kind of color. And as I said before, the chassis takes a lot of time because of the many screws. It's the same here on the body stickers. With this, I'm not so fine. I think I will change it later. The window masking is always great. The rear and the front windows are made of four black stripes, each window, and for the front, there is a fifth stripe going up here, but this isn't an issue. The stickers for the front lights or headlights I didn't use. They made bubbles, or I had missed some cutting lines into it on the rear. It was fine. I had seen there were four cutting lines, so you can bend it around here. And I take another shortcut. It's hard to see. I didn't use the stickers here, here, and here. Here I use it, here not. Here I have some very good old stuff. This focus. So. This is trimline. These are stripes. You get them or got them in many colors. It isn't now available on the market. I think there are maybe some other products, but I like this. It can be bended or shaped in curves. It's very good, and I'm lucky that I have this. And you can use it on many cars or other functions to put it around there and get a really fine line. The advantage of this is I had only to work on the side of the body and not on the fender. So there wasn't an edge I have to put in and later hair dry it. Okay, all stickers are hair dried later to get a better contact to the body. And speaking of body work, this isn't the screw which is mentioned for this, as here. You've got here little plastic ones, and they gave you a 2.6 machine screw, but this won't work. I had ruined one of the screw heads. So I put a 3x8mm self-tapping screw in, and this bites really here in it, and it was done in a minute. The other thing I had done are these foam parts. And here, and so you can see it. See where the clip is pressed in here? It would probably ruin your paint job if you don't use some foam protection or some other things. So this is all I have to say for the build of the car and the body. And the next things I mentioned, although they might fit to the build or the body, while I'm talking about my experience with the drives I had done. I had driven the Unimog in my studio and in the forest, and I'm really happy with it. The performance is great, and it really works very long. I didn't have to change the battery for even an hour, and this is very good. But I think this might be somehow because I'm using, it's hard to see, this 29 turn 550 Enduro motor, which gives the car a lot of strength. And okay, it decreases the top speed, but it also improves the running time. The car runs on flat ground, a little bit wobbly, but I think this is okay. This is a crawler, and crawler should climb and not run on flat surfaces. The juice of the servo was very good too. I got no issues with it. The car steers very precise. It's a little bit dirty, although I cleaned it for over 1 hour. The quick run does an awesome job too, so I'm really fine with it. And speaking of the run in the forest, sometimes the car rolled over. I put this in my video too. And the side mirrors are really fine. They have a lot of flexibility. They didn't break or harm the body. I didn't found any scratches or paint getting off the body. So this is great too. And what I wanted to say. Oh yes, I know. I lost one of these body clips, but I think this is okay. For these body clips, I've many in my toolbox, and this was the only repair I have to do. This is great. Incomplete. In summary, for a crawler, this car is right out of the box very great. It has a low center of gravity because the motor is sitting down here. There are some things you might improve. You can put on metal axles, metal beadlock rims, barrel springs, and so on and so on. Tamiya has a lot of hot-ups for it, and there are a lot of aftermarket hop-ups. But this is left to everyone itself. One thing I'm not so happy about it, the differentials are a little bit loose till the lock works. This isn't so precise, but maybe there may be some other differentials you can put in which eliminate this little thing. On driving, you won't recognize it. Also, you don't recognize that these are lock differentials. The car didn't jump around in turns. This is very great. And speaking of unlocking the differentials, you have to loose the screw, turn the axle till you find the screw inside it, which really locks the differential, and then you have to get it out. I don't recommend to do this. You may lose the screw inside the gear housing, and then you've got a really problem and have to disassemble the complete axle. But for driving, you will not recognize it that these differentials are locked. And for the climbing ability, it's very good. The tires might be a little bit softer. I got spinning wheels on some slightly flat ground. Although they grip a little bit in the surface, but I have to increase the speed a little bit to get up some steep hills. My summary is that Tamiya made a great crawler right out of the box. Build it, drive it, have fun with it. If you want to, you can improve it. It's a crawler, it works as a crawler. In comparison to the TRX4 or the SCX10, this is a great car. Okay, it has only two RC functions. If you want to, you can upgrade the car with a rear wheel steering. The parts are in the kit, but you need a high torque servo saver and a second servo to do this. And of course, a radio with a third channel. You can do also with a Y cable, which I done on my G601. But for a crawler, I would better say a third channel and maybe separate steered, not mixed. And talking about the TRX4, you shouldn't compare it with a big five-channel car. You should compare it with the TRX4 Sport, which has lock differentials too. And there you are in the same price scale. For this, there are three models out there. This, a Toyota Land Cruiser, and some other car. The other car, I'm not sure how it's called, but it has no ball bearings. So I really appreciate to choose either the Unimog or the Land Cruiser. So you get all ball bearings inside the car. And adding another motor, servo, an ESC, the receiver and the radio channel. I think most of you out there have radios with more than one memory slot. Let's say 500 euros and you're good to go or to run with this car. Upgrades are every time possible. And I don't think this might be in the scale crawler section, although you get a very good base. You can upgrade this, there's no matter to it. But the thing is, you've got a really low center of gravity right from the start. And if you add some more weight here on the body, then you lose this advantage. So leave it as it is. Upgrade the springs, maybe the axles, maybe the motor. I'm just thinking about putting a 35-turn motor in to get some more force and some longer time to drive. Next year, when the weather's better, I think I do a marathon with it and really test out how long this can drive. But I think up to 2 hours might be realistic, depending on what you do with this car. So I thank the RC Elf once again for donating me this awesome car. I thank you, dear viewers, for standing with me along of all those videos I done off schedule this month. In January, I will go back to the normal schedule with Friday evening videos on Central Europe time. My next project, the Super Hot Shot, is still in work and will be presented along in January. On New Year's Eve, there's just another video, which is made for all of my three channels. And this will be the year in review. I think it's quite interesting. I found some very nice memories of this year. And I hope you see it and enjoy it. And so long, Happy New Year, and see you soon on Aussie Birds.